In Lord of the World, Robert Hugh Benson presents a dystopian vision of the future, exploring themes of spirituality, technology, and the clash between secularism and religious faith. Published in 1907, the novel eerily foreshadows the potential consequences of an increasingly secularized society dominated by technology and politics. Set in the 21st century, Lord of the World portrays a world divided into three major powers: the secularist West, the theocratic East, and the United States of America. The protagonist, Julian Felsenburgh, emerges as a charismatic and enigmatic figure who rises to global prominence as a political leader, renowned for his exceptional oratory skills. Felsenburgh embodies a messianic persona, drawing mass followings and unifying disparate ideologies under the banner of humanism. Benson's exploration of spirituality is central to the novel. The religious and philosophical beliefs of the characters play a significant role in shaping their worldviews and actions. The Vatican represents the stronghold of traditional Christianity, clinging to faith and moral values despite the allure of Felsenburgh's secular humanism. Father Percy Franklin, a British priest, exemplifies this internal struggle as he grapples with his convictions amid the changing world. Through Father Franklin, Benson examines the challenges faced by religious figures and institutions in a society hostile to faith. The novel's portrayal of technology is striking, given its early 20th century publication. Benson envisages advanced technological innovations that closely mirror our contemporary reality. Air travel, video conferencing, and mass media play pivotal roles in shaping global affairs, showcasing the author's prescience in foreseeing the direction of modern civilization. The clash between secularism and religious faith serves as the novel's central conflict. Benson portrays a world where the state has become the new religion, demanding complete allegiance from its citizens. In contrast, traditional religious beliefs are relegated to the private sphere, suppressed and marginalized. This struggle reaches its zenith in the United States, where Christianity is outlawed, and a form of secular worship is enforced through the Church of the Spirit of Man. Julian Felsenburgh's messianic persona and meteoric rise to power symbolized the seductive allure of secular humanism. He becomes a symbol of hope and progress for the world, promising a utopian society devoid of religious conflicts and moral dilemmas. Yet, beneath his charismatic exterior lies a darker reality, one that threatens to strip humanity of its spiritual essence. Felsenburgh's eventual revelation as the Lord of the World signifies the dangers of elevating any human to the status of a deity, as he ushers in a new era of totalitarian rule. Benson also explores the role of suffering and sacrifice in shaping human character and faith. Characters like Mabel Brand epitomize selflessness, finding solace in their suffering, while others, like the atheist scientist Oliver Brand, ultimately lose hope and despair in the face of adversity. Through these contrasting experiences, the novel delves into the complex relationship between human suffering and spiritual resilience. In conclusion, Lord of the World by Robert Hugh Benson presents a thought-provoking literary analysis of a dystopian future dominated by secularism and technology. The novel's exploration of spirituality, technology, and the clash between secularism and religious faith remains highly relevant in our modern world. Benson's cautionary tale serves as a reminder of the importance of maintaining a delicate balance between progress and the preservation of our spiritual essence. As readers, we are prompted to reflect on the implications of our choices and the potential consequences of disregarding the fundamental aspects of our humanity.